The FCLE competition of 2011 maintained a proud tradition of attracting writers from all genres, prose fiction, non-fiction, poetry, and drama. We thank all the writers who entered the competition and extend our congratulations to the winners. The writers, whether domiciled at home in Barbados or New York, have painted pictures and spun tales that signal and send strong clues about the location of their navel strings. For many of us, the momentous events taking place in the turbulent world environment overshadow the peace and sense of security which pervade our dreams. Viewed within this context of instability and changing fortunes at home and abroad, the entries to the competition demonstrated that human beings have other concerns, many of which have been indelibly etched in their psyche through the experiences of time, their inner struggles with the demons of life, and through living, loving, and sometimes hating. Writers in particular, those who submit their work to be judged in competitions by persons who don't know them personally, display a sense of courage and trust that must be respected. In fact, it places an obligation on the judges of competitions such as this not to be arbitrary in their decisions. Clearly, every poem or novel will not be interesting to every reader. So the challenge is enormous, particularly within the context of what is seen by many as the comparison of oranges and apples. The challenge of judging the FCLE competition is an experience that many of us treasure and have undertaken as a solemn commitment for the last 14 years. The early discussions, for example, of the FCLE were focused on the most effective ways of maintaining Collymore's legacy in its program. Of course, the platform he provided for talented writers through the publication of BIM magazine cannot be overlooked. Hence, the window of opportunity provided by the growing ebook environment is certainly appropriate for the furtherance of the Collymore ethos. The reality of life is that success cannot be guaranteed, and the literary experience can only be enjoyed if works are exposed through publication. It is evident that many writers in Barbados are self-publishing, but when one considers the range of excellent work which has been submitted to the FCLE over the years, it is imperative that we find a way, with the permission of the writers, of course, of making these works available to the reading public. The Central Bank is now making its reports available online, and considering that technology has advanced towards a growing ebook environment, it is suggested that the bank's online technologies should be utilized to facilitate cost-effective publication of the best of the works submitted to its annual competition. The cultural challenges we face in Barbados are enormous, and the factors of change will only be placed in perspective if our people are able to share their stories of life experiences within their historical context of time and place. Stories told and related from the safety of anonymous characters that touch because of our responsiveness to the lore of language and its affinity to the rhythm of life. Our writers must be encouraged to follow and be directed by their visions, unfettered by the constraints of box mentality, but inspired by the power of the written word to motivate and affect change across the globe. The continuing support of the bank for the work of the FCLE is critical to our existence, and the bank must be commended for its unselfish demonstration of a social conscience. To the governor, Dr. World, we say thank you. Our gratitude is extended to the team at the FCH, Fran Wickham Jacobs, Joanna Hines, and Joanna Schillingfield-Holder, for their support throughout the year, as well as Marilyn Ford, our recording secretary, for her work. To the members of the committee, Dame Patricia Simmons, De Carla Applewhite, Professor Jane Bryce, Christine Matthews, Juanita Wade, Professor Mark McWatt, Esther Phillips, and Andy Tate. Thanks for your hard work, cooperation, and dedication. I thank you.